Hello, my name is Alex, and I would like to introduce you to Babbage, my prototype Telepresence rover. In this series of videos, I will be going over the design process and construction of this robot, and specifically some of the challenges I faced during construction. I'll be going over all of the hardware, software components, and the design elements that make them all work together. So what is telepresence? Telepresence is the ability to project yourself remotely using technology with a virtually augmented experience. So when I talk about augmented reality, I'm referring to the ability to see the world through the robot's eyes and to hear what it hears, and on top of that, overlaying all of the data from its array of sensors onto a heads-up display. In a future video, I'll go over all the code and integration necessary to take full advantage of the Rift. Alright, so here's a high-level diagram of Babbage's components and how they're connected. Babbage is made up out of several layers supported by plexiglass sheets. The base of the chassis holds the wheels and optical speedometers, an Arduino Uno attached to an Adafruit motor shield which controls the wheels and the servos, and the Arduino Nano, which takes data from the sensors including the compass, accelerometer, and two sonar rangefinders. The second level supports the head servos the cameras are mounted to, as well as the sonar. The third level is dedicated to power distribution and holds three voltage regulators. The fourth contains the circuitry that connects them to the battery and also supports the two BeagleBones, and the fifth holds the battery in place. Babbage is powered by a 12-volt CLED acid battery. I went through a number of battery configurations, and this one seemed to work the best. At first I tried using banks of AAA batteries, but I quickly found that they didn't supply enough power to run everything at once. I decided on a CLED acid battery because despite the weight, they deliver a high enough current to run multiple systems simultaneously. The onboard computers require a 5-volt power supply, so I thought a 6-volt battery stepped down to 5 volts using a simple 7805 voltage regulator would be enough. The 7805 steps on voltage and sheds the energy as heat. The problem was that it wasted a lot of energy, decreasing the battery life. Also, it got really hot. I did some research and found something called a buck step-down converter. That's a regulator that uses an integrated circuit to efficiently drop the voltage to a usable level. It only draws as much current as it needs to send out, and you can get them on eBay for under $3, including shipping, which is pretty great. Then I found out about something called a dropout voltage, which meant that having a regulator drop down to a voltage so close to the battery's voltage just wouldn't work. I needed a bigger battery, but by this time I had already built most of the physical structure, so I needed to have a battery Babbage could actually carry. I found a 12-volt battery that weighed it down a little, but puts out enough power to run everything at once. Now I know someone's going to point out how I should have used a lithium polymer battery, which I did consider, because they're smaller and more lightweight, but... Given that I fried Babbage at least twice from crosswiring, I didn't really want to take that risk. Since one camera eye and one BeagleBone computer takes up 2 amps, and the servos take up 1 amp each, I put on 3 regulators, one for the motors and servos, and two for the computers and eyes. The BeagleBones are the main processors on the robot, and also serve as communication hubs to connect to my MacBook and the phone. The BeagleBone Black is a small hobby computer that runs the Linux OS. There's a lot of open source software that I can take advantage of. For example, a program called MJPEG Streamer, which I use to stream video from the cameras through the BeagleBone to the laptop. Each BeagleBone talks to one Arduino computer via USB. One reads info from the sensors, and the other controls the motors and head servos. I started with one BeagleBone, but after wiring up the cameras, I discovered that the USB port doesn't have enough bandwidth to stream from both of them. So I added a second. This also allotted more processing power to each system. Babbage also has a Nokia phone to provide GPS information, speech recognition, text-to-speech, and lightweight ballistic armor. It's connected via Wi-Fi to the BeagleBones and the laptop. The reason I use Arduinos and the BeagleBone doesn't drive the motors and servos directly is because the Arduino is a very popular platform for electronic prototyping, so it has lots of code examples and compatible hardware available online for a wide range of applications. For example, the Arduino Uno controlling the motor uses an Adafruit motor shield, which simplifies the task of controlling the motors. For communication between the BeagleBones and Arduinos, I use a robotics framework called Johnny 5. The nice thing about Johnny 5 is that it allows me to make quick software prototypes in JavaScript, and it's compatible with plenty of hardware components. Most of the heavy lifting in terms of computing is done on the MacBook. This includes things like facial recognition, object tracking, coordination, and general decision making. The Mac sends commands to the BeagleBone, which in turn relays commands to the Arduinos. The video stream from the eyes is relayed to an Oculus Rift, which, if you don't know what that is, it's a virtual reality headset which lets me see through Babbage's cameras. The nice thing about the Oculus Rift is that it has an extremely accurate 6-axis accelerometer, which not only tracks my head movements, but also predicts them. I use this data to control Babbage's head so I can look around from the ROAS perspective. I mounted an elite motion detector onto the Rift, which reads hand gestures. This lets me drive and steer using my hands. Here's a clip of my little sister helping me test out the leap motion. The distance of the hand from the sensor determines the speed of the wheels on that side, and making a fist puts it in reverse. For testing, I just made a joystick out of spare Arduino, which is a bit easier to use at the moment. In each video of the series, I'm going to be giving a more detailed, step-by-step explanation of how each system is built. In the next video, I'll be going over the process of wiring up the sonar rangefinder system. So, I'll see you then. Bye.